Today we're doing math pages 199 and 200. 199 and 200. We'll be working on something new called cancellation. Okay, as we look at 1A, the directions tell us to use cancellation when possible. Do not solve the problems. So we're not having to solve these problems, but we're just going to be using cancellation. And that's just part of the steps to solving these problems. Here's how it'll work. We've got to figure out the GCF, the greatest common factor that goes into 2, and down here, 8. What goes into both 2 and 8? 2 does. How many times does 2 go into 2? It goes in one time, so we'll cross out the 2 and we'll write a 1 right there. How many times does 2 go into 8? 4 times. And so we've changed our numbers to 1 and 4. And now we're going to cancel this number and this number by figuring out what's the greatest number that goes into both 5 and 5. Well, that's easy. 5 does. 5 goes into 5 one time, and 5 goes into 5 one time. And that's it. Now we're done with A. As we look at B, so we'll then look at this number and this number, figure out what the GCF for both of those are, and then we'll look at this number, and do the same thing. Let's start with the 3 and the 6. What goes into both 3 and 6? 3 goes into 3 one time, 3 goes into 6 two times. Okay, now we'll do our 4 and our 5. Now what goes into both 4 and 5? Nothing does except for 1, so we're not doing anything with the 4 and 5, because it can't be reduced. Let's look at C. We'll start with our 4 and our 10. What goes into both 4 and 10? 2 does. 2 goes into 4 two times, and 2 goes into 10 five times. Okay, let's look at our 9 and our 3. What goes into both 9 and 3? 3 goes into both 9 and 3. 3 goes into 9 three times, and 3 goes into 3 one time. And we're done. D, we look at our 5 and our 15 and ask ourselves, what goes into both 5 and 15? 5 does. 5 goes into 5 one time, and 5 goes into 15 three times. Now let's look at our 7 and our 14. What goes into both 7 and 14? 7 goes into 7 one time. 7 goes into 14 two times. Okay, we're going to do the same thing in number 2, but now we're going to move on to finishing the problem. After we do the cancellation, then we'll finish the problem. I'll go ahead and let you do E on your own. Remember, you're going to look at this number and this number, figure out what number goes into both of those, and then you'll do this and this, and figure out what number goes into both of those. Let's go ahead and look at 2A. Kind of blurry, sorry. What goes into 1 and 3? Well, 1 is the only number that does, so we won't do anything to those two, but now let's look at 2 and 2. What goes into both 2 and 2? 2 does. 2 goes into 2 one time. 2 goes into 2 one time. Now, we're going to just multiply across. 1 times 1 is 1. And 1 times 3 is 3. And our answer is 1/3. Okay, B. We have 2 and 6. What goes into both 2 and 6? 2 does. 2 goes into 2 one time, 2 goes into 6 three times. Now we'll look at 5 and 5. What goes into both those? 5 does. 5 goes into 5 one time, 5 goes into 5 one time. Now we just multiply across. 1 times 1 is 1, 1 times 3 is 3, and again our answer is 1/3. C. We're looking at our 4 and our 6. What goes into both 4 and 6? 2 does. 2 goes into 4 two times. 2 goes into 6 three times. Now we'll look at our 7 and 5. And there's not a number that will go in 7 and 5 besides 1, so we'll just leave that. And now we're ready to multiply across. 2 times 5 equals 10. 7 times 3 equals 21. And our answer is 10 over 21. D. We'll start by looking at our 3 and our 9. What goes into both 3 and 9? 3 does. 3 goes into 3 one time, 3 goes into 9 three times. Now we look at our 4 and our 4, and 4 goes into both of those. 4 goes into 4 one time, 4 goes into 4 one time. Now we're ready to multiply straight across. 1 times 1 equals 1. 1 times 3 equals 3. And our answer is 1/3. E. Let's look at our 8 and 4. What goes into both 8 and 4? 4 does. 4 goes into 8 two times. 4 goes into 4 one time. Now we'll look at our 9 and 3. What goes into both 9 and 3? 3 does. 3 goes into 9 three times. 3 goes into 3 one time. Now let's figure out our answer. 2 times 1 equals 2. 3 times 1 equals 3. And our answer is 2/3. F. What goes into both 3 and 6? 3 does. 3 goes into 3 one time, 3 goes into 6 two times. What goes into both 10 and 5? 5 does. 5 goes into 10 two times, 5 goes into 5 one time. Now we're ready to multiply across. 1 times 1 equals 1. 2 times 2 equals 4. And our answer is 1/4. G. We're going to look at 1 and 5. There's nothing we can do to 1 and 5. 1 is the biggest number that goes into both of those. So we'll leave those. But our 4 and 2, we can do something to that. 2 goes into both 4 and 2. 2 goes into 4 two times, and 2 goes into 2 one time. And our answer is 1/10. H. 3 times. Let's look at the 3 and 6. What goes into both 3 and 6? 3 does. 3 goes into 3 one time. 3 goes into 6 two times. Okay, what goes into 11 and 5? Nothing does besides 1. So we'll leave that. Now we go ahead and solve it. 1 times 5 equals 5. 11 times 2 equals 22. And so we get 5 over 22.
That's a lot. Because it would be 7, you're putting 1 plus and a half.
Okay, number 3, it tells us to fill in the blank.
Why is it thinking to me?
Okay, sorry. Fill in the blank with the correct number. So what we have to do is figure out what needs to go here, what needs to go there. Now remember, 1 always equals any number over itself. So A here would be 7 over 7 equals 1. Just like in B, 9 over 9 equals 1. Alright, D, we've got to figure out 9 times, 9 times what is going to equal 63? 9 times what equals 63? 9 times 7 is going to be 63. So if we do a times 7 right here, we need to do a times 7 here. And 8 times 7 equals 56. And that's our answer. Okay. E, 11 times what? Equals 132. 11 times 12 equals 132. So we got to do 4 times 12. 4 times 12 is 48. Let's go ahead and look at the story problem number 5. It says Dylan has read 2/3 of the book of Acts. Allison has read half as much in Acts as Dylan has. What part of Acts has Allison read? So, we know that Dylan read 2/3 of it. I'm going to kind of make a picture here. If this was a bar showing how much of Acts Dylan read, well, he read 2/3 of it. So he read all of this. If you were to divide Acts into 3 parts, he read 2 out of the 3 parts. Now we know that Allison read half how much he read. So if we cut this in half, that's how much Allison read. So Allison read only 1 out of the 3 parts. And that'd be 1/3. She read 1/3 of Acts. Okay, B, I'm going to have you guys do on your own. You just got to figure out what this number in Roman numerals is. Let's look at number 6. It's telling us to change it to improper fractions. So remember, we go 3 times 3 plus 2. We go the whole number times the denominator plus the top number, the numerator. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 2 more is 11. And then you keep your denominator, 11/3. 11/3. Okay, so you guys are doing the rest on your own. You can do it. I believe in you. You guys are so smart. But just to help you finish strong here, let's do a little Bible trivia. Alright, and so these are going to all be true and false questions. True and false questions. Let's go ahead and look at the first one. First one says God used Adam's rib bone from his side to create Eve. So you got to decide if that's true or false. Go ahead and stand up if you think that is true. Okay, go ahead and stand up if you think that is false. And the correct answer is, when God created Eve, he did use Adam's rib bone. That is true. Okay, second question. God led Abraham to the Mount of Olives to sacrifice his young son, Isaac. Okay, go ahead and stand up if you think this is true. Go ahead and stand up if you think this is false. This one is false. He led him to a place called Mount Sinai, not the Mount of Olives. Okay, let's do two more. When Jesus was arrested, the disciples stayed by his side. Stand up if you think that is true. Go ahead, stand up if you think that is false. The correct answer is false. Sadly, it's false. They actually ran away from him. And Jesus said this would happen. Okay, last one. You know how whenever we're praying, we say amen at the end of a prayer? The word amen means that a prayer is finished. Is that true or false? Stand up if you think that's true. Stand up if you think that is false. That is false. False. What it really means is it signifies an agreement with what has been said. It's like you're agreeing with what's been said. So if somebody prays something and you say amen, you're saying, yes, I agree with that. Okay, go ahead and do the rest on your own. You guys are amazing. Amen.